Hey friends, welcome back to Walt Christie World, where I talk about all things Disney pins and Disney merch and whatever else Disney I can think of. So today I have the March Terrarium pin to show you, so let's get started. So I've showed the other two Terrarium pins on this channel, and now I have March in hand. I actually got it right after when I normally would film my video last week. So I didn't have a video last week because I didn't have anything really to do. And also I was just really busy. It was a busy week. So I could have come up with something different to do, but I just decided to take a week off. So I got this on like Tuesday or Wednesday and wanted to share it with you. All right, so this is a monthly series. It's coming out at both parks, or both coasts, I guess, in the States. And it's called Where Fantasy Grows. Each of the pins is the same shape on the outside and then a different character in the background. We've gotten Bambi and Flower in the first one, Pascal in the second one, and now Flit from Pocahontas. So let's take it off the backer card, check it out. I still really love this series and am like every month excited to see what the next one will be. And so far, these are all characters that I don't really have pins that feature them. So it's nice to have a little, you know, something different for my collection. So yeah, the colors on this one are really, really beautiful. I love the blues. And this one is like the last one where the glass is only on the bottom two, which I thought was kind of interesting that they decided to change that after the first pin, but whatever. It's limited edition 4,000. I guess I can show you the back. I mean, it's the same as the other two really, but super cute pin. These retail for $19.99. And then of course, you know, if you have an annual pass, you can get a discount. And when I get them, I think my pickup total is like 23. So, I can double check that. I'm pretty sure that's what it is. So he's basically just charging me like the cost of the pin plus shipping. So it's a really good deal. If you're interested in doing pickups for stuff like this, if you're like me and you don't live near the parks, let me know. I can add you or just send you a link to the Facebook group that this guy has so that you can see when he's doing pickups if you want to try it out. It's been really good for me. I don't want to do stuff like this a lot because part of me just feels like the people at the parks should be able to be the ones to buy the merch because they're the ones paying all the money to get there. But then the other part of me is like, well, I mean, I don't know. It's complicated. Like, I will never support the eBay sellers that will go buy the pins or whatever merch it is and then sell it for a huge markup. I'm not gonna support that, but people who do park pickups, like, it's just a really nice thing to do to help people get the merchandise that they would like when they can't go to the parks, which is especially true right now. There's a lot of people that can't go to the parks. Disneyland hasn't even been open, so the only people that are going there are the people that live there and can go to Downtown Disney. So I don't know where I'm going with this. I'm just saying park pickups has been nice. Also, I hate Shop Disney, like, hate it. So I've just about decided I'm not gonna buy stuff on Shop Disney anymore, even if it's pins, unless it's something I really, 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 really like, because the packaging is always terrible, and you'll hear some people say they're getting better. No, every once in a while, they package something like 50% effort, and everybody's like, oh, they did a good job. No. Every single package that comes to me from Shop Disney should be packaged well. It makes no sense to me. Like, they will literally throw four $20 pins in a box this big with no bubble wrap, nothing. And it's just, it makes no sense. So anyway, I don't like Shop Disney. And I ordered this sweatshirt from them a while back. It came in, it was too big. I was like, okay, I mean, I don't love this as much as I thought I would anyway, so I was gonna return it. Well, they didn't have a return label in the box like most companies do now. Like, that's a standard thing for a big company, not for like a small shop, but a big company. They usually include a prepaid shipping label if you need to return or exchange. No big deal. Not Shop Disney. And I went on Shop Disney's website, and there's nowhere for me to like initiate a return where I get a label emailed to me, which is another thing that a lot of companies do. So I just let it sit there for a little while, and then finally I decided, okay, I'm just gonna send this back. I'm not gonna exchange it because it's too much trouble. There's nowhere online for me to like start an exchange. So I just sent it back and I said, I wanna return this. And somehow they, I don't know if I like emailed them at one point to request a return label, something like that. They had like noted that I wanted to exchange it for a different size instead of what I put on the slip inside the package was return it, give me my money back, whatever. So I got the other shirt in the mail after like a month and a half after I sent it and it was received. It was just, Disney is a huge company. I don't understand why their online or e-commerce is so bad. And I'm going to stop ranting about it because I know you came here for pins and now I'm just ranting about Shop Disney and talking about random stuff. But it's okay. Sometimes random videos are good and I haven't been on here to talk very much. So here I am talking, rambling. And if you have the same complaints, let me know in the comments. We can just, I don't know, complain about it together. Okay, so next week I don't really have anything planned. So if you have anything you want me to talk about, let me know. I did think about going over some of the stuff we did in our fall trip because I said I was going to do that and I never did. So if I don't get any suggestions otherwise, I will just plan on doing that. And I'll include some pictures and things so you're not just staring at my face. Also, yeah, I don't know if you can tell from this like small video, but I'm extremely tired today. I don't know what it is. I went to bed at my normal time last night, but I think I'm gonna like take a nap instead of eat lunch today. So that's where we're at. But anyway, like I said, last week was really busy, so maybe I just need to catch up. All right, I will see y'all in the next one, and I hope you have a very magical week. Bye.